Making GIFs in Photoshop is actually super quick, easy, and fun. And in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you step by step exactly how you can make a GIF in just a few minutes too. Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel dedicated to helping you become a better food photographer. Now, in today's video, we are going to be looking at a step-by-step guide to making GIFs in Photoshop. And with the recent changes to Instagram, I know that I as a photographer and many other photographers are looking for ways to be adding motion and video to their content for social media. So for me, GIFs are a really easy way to just convert a series of still images that I've taken into something moving and fun and eye-catching for social media. So in food photography, it's really easy to create GIFs out of action shots and movement shots. So for example, if you're pouring syrup onto pancakes, if you're pouring a drink, maybe you're dusting icing sugar onto a cupcake, all of these actions can really easily be converted into a GIF. So you need to be setting your camera to be taking multiple shots really quickly, one after the other. Mine usually takes 10, very, very fast. And then you can import those images into whatever software you use to edit them all to look exactly the same, and then we can import them into Photoshop, which I'm going to show you how to do in just a moment, and you'll make that into a little animated GIF. Without further ado, let's get right into that tutorial. Okay, here we are in Photoshop, ready to create our GIF. So to begin, we're going to click File and Scripts, then Load Files into Stack. So here we are assuming that you have already prepared and edited your images for the GIF, and we click Browse and we navigate to the folder where you have saved those edited images. So here I have prepared some apricots. You may have seen this already on my Instagram. So we're going to recreate this little GIF here. We're going to click Open, and these files are going to load into this box here. There is an option to attempt to automatically align the sources automatically in Photoshop, but I normally shoot my GIFs on a tripod, so each image should already be aligned anyway. So I normally do not select this. And then we just click OK. Then you will see that each of the images is going to be loaded into a separate layer in the panel over here on the right. And now we need to make them into our GIF. So we want to have this timeline panel at the bottom of Photoshop open. If you don't see this, then you just navigate to Window and Timeline and just make sure there's a tick next to it and it will show up at the bottom of your window. So we are simply going to click Create Frame Animation, and you'll see that the first image is showing here on our timeline. And to get all the rest of the images to show up in the timeline as well, we're just going to click on these lines here on the right hand side and select Make Frames from Layers. And you will see these have now all appeared in my timeline. Now, usually these do actually show up in the correct order that I've numbered them in, but this time I think my numbering technique was slightly off, so they have not appeared in the right order. So I'm just going to drag and drop these into the order that I want so that we're seeing these this plate of apricots construct itself one apricot at a time. I think we're there. Good. All right, so now we can see these are all appearing one after the other. And if I click play, the GIF is going to play really quickly. So that's very, very fast. As you can see, it's playing on a non-stop loop. That's because here I have the looping time set as forever. You can also choose 3 times or just once. I normally leave it on forever, but I need to make it a bit slower because it's far too fast. So to select all of these frames, we're going to select number one, hold down the shift key and click on the last image in your timeline, and all of them will be selected. And then you can choose this little drop down arrow here to select the amount of time you would like each frame to be shown. So I'm going to select all of them to be shown for 0.2 seconds. Of course, you can choose individual ones to be shown for longer or shorter if you want. It depends on what it is that you're creating, but I normally set all of mine to show for the same amount of time. So I'm going to select 0.2, and now we can see if we click play that it's at a lot slower and a lot more easy to see what is happening. So here you already have a GIF. You can save your GIF like this, literally just looping on a single round, but you might also want to do some extra little bits and pieces. So for this one, I want to show the apricot plate constructing up until the final image, and then I want to also reverse it and kind of deconstruct the plate of apricot, so it's a more continuous loop. So to do that, I'm just going to click stop, and we're basically going to replicate and copy the frames and repeat them behind the selection. So what I mean is we're going to, again, use the shift key to select all of the frames. Then I'm going to click these lines here and click copy frames, re-click those lines and select paste frames. And then I have an option of where I want them, where I want Photoshop to paste my selection. So I'm going to paste it after my selection. We're going to click OK. And you'll see now they have placed themselves straight after my selection, but I want them to go the other way. I want them to be reversed. So again, click these magic lines and we click reverse frames. And now you can see that my plate of apricots is constructing and deconstructing on a continuous looping GIF. Might take a moment for it to render and play properly, but it does. So there we have it. You can play around as much as you like until you've created the GIF that you are happy with and that you want to upload. So let's look at now how to save this as either an MP4 or as a GIF. So to save, we can click File and Export. And if you want to save it as a GIF, you can click Save for Web Legacy, and this will save it as a .gif file. Okay, so here's the window for saving it for web or saving it as a GIF file. So here we can select what we want it to save as, and this is where you select GIF. I normally leave all of these options as they are, like this, so adaptive, diffusion. We're not going to go into all of these right now, but this is normally what I save all of these settings as. And the only thing I change is the image size, because this is really quite big. And my default is to just change it to width 600, height 900. And that will be big enough or small enough to save and to upload to social media and still be good enough quality to see. So it just takes a moment to kind of shrink that file size and then we can save it. Great. So now I just hit save and you can choose your destination and save it as a GIF here. Alternatively, we can also save this as an MP4. So I'm just going to click cancel. And to do that, you again click File, Export and Render Video, and this will give you the option to save it as an MP4. So again, you can give it whatever name you like and select the folder you want it to be saved in. Let's just pop this on the desktop for now, and you can choose what quality you want it to be saved in. We're just going to go for the HDTV for now and click Render. Okay, so that has saved. Now if I just go to my desktop, we should be able to open this and we'll see the MP4 GIF playing. And that's how you have just created in 5 minutes a really nice and easy GIF. All right, there you have it, a really quick and easy tutorial on making GIFs in Photoshop. I hope you loved today's video and that you now feel empowered to go and make a GIF yourself. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. You can leave a comment down below letting me know what you think and what you'd like to see from me in the future. And of course, I'd love it if you hit that subscribe button and you won't miss out on any future videos from me. Have a great day today. Thanks so much for joining me, and I will see you in the next video.